हेलो 11th क्लास, दिस इज योर सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर साइंस, चैप्टर 6 रिवीजन। द चैप्टर नेम इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू पाइथन। सो इन दिस क्लास वी विल रिवाइज द चैप्टर 6। सो आई एम जस्ट डिवाइडिंग दिस रिवीजन इन टू पार्ट्स। ओके, सो टुडे वी विल रिवाइज द हाफ पार्ट एंड टुमारो वी विल रिवाइज नेक्स्ट पार्ट। ओके, सो नाउ जस्ट लेट्स गेट स्टार्ट। इंट्रोडक्शन। This Python was created by Guido van Rossum. This language was released in February 1991. Python got its name from a BBC comedy series from 70s, that is Monty Python's Flying Circus. Python can be used to follow both procedural approach and the object-oriented approach of programming. It is free to use. Anybody can use it. Python is based on or influenced with two programming languages, that is ABC language and the modular 3 language. Okay, ABC language, that is the replacement of the BASIC. The features which make Python so popular, so these are, first one is easy to use object oriented language, expressive language, interpreted language, its completeness, cross platform language, free and open source, variety of usage application. So the first one is easy to use. Now I am just explaining every feature. The first is the easy to use. So this Python is compact and very easy to use object oriented language because it has its own rule and it is a high level language and it is very programmer friendly language. Expressive language, in this the code are easy to express as compared to other language. For example, there is a code of swapping. So in C++, the code is int a is equal to 2, b is 3 and temp. Now temp is equal to a is equal to b, b is equal to temp. So this is the code for C++. But in Python, how will you write? This is a comma b, 2 comma 3 and a comma b is equal to, you have to just replace the value b comma a. So that a will get 2 and b will get 3. Now next is interpreted language. So it is interpreted, not compiled language. Thus executes code line by line and it makes Python easy to debug and suitable for beginners and advanced users. Interpreter means it will convert the code in machine language line by line and in the compiler will convert the code. The compiler will convert the whole program at once. Next is its completeness. So Python is a complete language. When you install it, so you do not install any other additional libraries. Okay, all the packages are just installed in Python itself. So the functionality is available with Python additional libraries. The features like web page, database connectivity, GUI features are available in this Python standard library. Okay, so next is cross platform language. So Python that can run on any language, only on any platform, that is on Windows, Linux, Unix. Okay, it can run on any language, it can run on any platform. So basically the Python is a portable language. It is a free and open source language. So it is freely available on this site. You can download it directly. Next is variety of usage or application where you will use it. So Python is being used in many diverse fields application, some of which are scripting, web applications, game development, system administrations, rapid prototyping, GUI programs, database applications. So these are the applications of Python and many more are there. Some limitations of Python's are not the fastest language, lesser libraries than C, Java, Perl, not strong on type binding. So now we have to discuss these one by one. So not the fastest language, because of its interpreted nature, Python is not fast as compared to compiled language. Python is first compiled into an internal bytecode, which is then executed by the Python interpreter. Next is lesser libraries than C, Java and Perl. So Python offers library support for almost all computing programs, but its library is still not competent with languages like C, Java, as they have the large collection available. Okay, so Python have lesser library as compared to these languages. Next is not strong on type binding. So Python is not very strong on data type checking, that is type mismatch issues will come. For example, if you declare variable as integer but later you have to store it in string value, so Python will not raise any error. Now, not easily convertible. So due to its lack of syntax, Python is easy to program, but it becomes a disadvantage when it comes to translate the Python program to another language. Okay, now working in Python, how will you work in Python? So before you start Python, you have to install the Python in your computer. So there are multiple distributions that are available today. So first is the, you have to click on this code. So from python.org is called the CPython installation and comes with Python interpreter, that is IDLE, and a pip package installer. This is the Anaconda that you want to install. It is another platform. So in such highly recommended distribution that comes with preloaded many packages and libraries, this is NumPy, SkyPy, Panda, etc. And other popular IDs are Spider, PyCharm. Spider IDs is available as a part of the Anaconda. Okay, but here we have to just install the simple one, that is simple Python IDLE. Okay, that is free of cost. Next is working modes in Python. So there are two modes, that is interactive mode, immediate mode, or the script mode. Okay, these two modes are in Python. So working in default CPython distribution, so the default installation of Python comes with Python interpreter and the Python IDLE. Okay, to work in the interactive mode or script mode, it depends on you. So in interactive mode, you have to follow this process. So click on the start button, then all program, then Python, then IDLE. Or you can click on start button, all program, and the command line. So I prefer the first one. Next is working in the interactive mode. So in interactive mode means one command at a time. One command will execute at a single time. So this Python execute the given command and give the output at a time. So in interactive mode, we type command at IDLE mode in front of this. For example, if you want to add 20 plus 30 in form of IDLE prompt, so what will you write? You have to just write 20 plus 30, it will give you 50. Okay. Next is from the above example, you can see that these three angular brackets are there. So we have to just give the command to execute, and Python will execute it if it is a error free, otherwise it will give you error. Now working in the script mode, so in this you have to write the multiple command and you have to save the complete file. Okay, so when you save the file, it will save the file with the extension .py. So you have to write the name of the file and then you have to execute it. Okay, so this is the script mode. Now creating the script or module, how will you create? So in Python, ideally click on the file, then click on new. So new window type. In window type command, you have to write the name of the program. So save your file, and your file will always save with the .py extension. And if you forget to write .py, so it will automatically take the name. So this is the screenshots of how will you write in script mode. So first you have to click on file, then new window, then this window will come. Here you have to just write the code, you have to save the file, and it will give you the result. Okay. Now analyzing script and output. So you have to type the code in the script file, this one. When you execute the script file, the output will be only hello world will get print. Okay, so this first line, this hash is there, so it means it is a single line comment. So it will not execute it by the compiler or the interpreter, because it is comment and it is ignored by the Python interpreter. Next is understanding print statement. So the print is basically a function whatever you want to write in parentheses and in inverted commas, so that will be visible on the output screen. Okay, you can write it either in single quote or in double quote. It will take both values. So this Python allows both single quotation and the double quotation. So both will be, it will take both the values. Okay. Next is, you have to remember some point. Python is a case sensitive. That is, it will treat small letter and capital letter differently. So we can use arrow and the down arrow to select the previous command and press the enter to recall and execute. Print statement is required only while working with the script mode. Otherwise, in interactive mode, values can be printed without print statement. Okay. I hope this revision, some topic that is not clear to you, you have to, these topics are clear now. So if you have any doubt, you have to just see the complete video of that particular topic of that particular chapter. Okay. So your homework is, again, you have to just revise it. And if you have not read, prepare the notes, so you have to prepare your notes. So thank you and have a nice day.